Hello, everyone. The show must go on. Although we cannot be together this evening, we wanted to make sure we still had our banquet to induct our new thespians, recap our season, announce our new season, and honor our seniors, and do all of this as a theater community together. First, each of the directors from this season's show will give a recap of their productions. First is Joan.
Hey, everybody. The first show of the school year was Schoolhouse Rock Live, in case you forgot. Probably not. It was a blast for me to do this show as my first time directing. Our cast of 18 was strong all the way through and so wonderful to work with. Your flexibility and willingness to try things made the rehearsal process so much fun. And our crew did an amazing job with the ever-growing list of props that were needed to make the show happen. That combined with the amazing projections AJ did made for a very successful show. Thank you guys so much. It was great. Next up is Ms. Moore.
The winter show was Radium Girls, and we had a talented cast and crew, and we had a successful run. I know it was a bit of a departure to work on such a serious play, but overall it gave everyone a great opportunity to work on some realistic character development, and our older crowd really enjoyed reliving memories of a challenging time within their own lifespan. So the lobby conversation was really positive, and it was great. I want to thank everyone who gave their time, their talents, to help with the show, and also just to create more opportunities for students to practice their theater artistry. Now, Mr. Garls.
Our spring musical was the musical that never happened. In February, auditions were held for Mamma Mia. We cast and got just over halfway through the rehearsal process before all activities were put on hold and then canceled for the remainder of the school year. Highlights for me were the dancing and singing of familiar songs, thanks to Joan and Alyssa's time and efforts. The ensemble definitely had a difficult but very fun job. The sad part is we were just starting character development and blocking when rehearsals had to come to an end. Thank you to everyone that put in the time and effort, and to the crew and orchestra who barely or never really got started. Hopefully we'll be able to put forth all productions in the 2021 season. Next, our thespian officers will lead us in the induction ceremony of new members into our thespian troupe.
Good evening. My name is Sylvia Kemp, and I am the president of Troop 4718 of Montemita High School. At this time, I would like to introduce the officers of our troop. Vice President and ZPAP Representative Anna Martinson, Membership Chairs Zala Pearson and John Scripp, Social Media Liaison Jordan Rollinger, and ZPAF Representative and MHS State Thespian Officer Representative Genevieve Lavallier.
Friends, parents, instructors, directors, and special guests, it is a pleasure to welcome you here to share in the induction of 8 members into the Matamidi High School's Troop 4718 of the International Thespian Society. Through hard work, sacrifice, and dedication, the candidates have earned sufficient points on a scale dictated by the International Thespian Society to have a right to be called thespians. It is a title of honor, signifying a commitment to an art as old as humanity.
Commitment to theater is what the International Thespian Society is all about. The society was established in 1929 at Fairmount State College, Fairmount, West Virginia, by Dr. Earl Blank, who was then the director of dramatics at the high school in Casper, Wyoming, Dr. Paul Opp, a member of the college faculty, and Harry Leeper, a teacher at East Fairmount High School.
They named their organization the National Thespian Society, or Thespis the Greek, who according to legend was the first actor. Their guiding principle was a dedication to excellence in theater arts in secondary schools. 71 schools became charter members of the society. The first national convention and election of officers was held in 1930. From this modest beginning, the organization enjoyed steady growth, and in the next 50 years, the membership had increased to 320 troops. The national office was moved to Cincinnati, Ohio in 1935. By the time the society had celebrated its 50th anniversary, there were 3,190 troops on its rolls.
At that point, the society had grown into an international organization with more than 2.2 million members and troops in every state and many foreign countries. The society sponsors state, regional, national, and international theater conferences where its members can learn more about the art and craft of theater, perform and see outstanding performances, and audition for scholarships.
In 1989, the governing board of the Thespian Society formed the Educational Theater Association to help it provide a broader range of services to the theater educators. The Educational Theater Association is a professional organization for theater teachers that includes in its membership all thespian troupe directors. Its board now operates the International Thespian Society, continuing its 91-year tradition of honoring and serving theater students and their teachers.
The goals of the International Thespian Society haven't changed. It still strives to give young adults a place for outstanding theater, where the standards of excellence in theater arts will be advanced, and to honor those students who do theater well. And it continues to be guided by the principles of its founders, a belief that participation in the arts is an essential means of widening students' cultural horizons and enriching their lives.
The following is from the speech delivered by playwright Robert Patrick at the Thespian Society's 50th anniversary celebration during the 1978 Thespian Festival. For 20,000 years, we humans have had what we called impossible dreams. Space travel, time travel, telepathy, to live other lives, to raise the dead, to create living creatures, to live forever, eternal youth, unity with our fellow humans.
Philosophers and spiritualists have used magic, alchemy, intellect, voodoo, and physics in quest of these goals. Some have been attained by science, some still evade us. Some even science calls impossible. And yet for all these thousands of years, we have already possessed those treasures wherever there was an empty space, a poet, actors and an audience in theater.
Space travel, the bare stage behind me with a few words and a pantomime skill becomes the surface of the moon or the center of the earth. On this stage, we can be in Arabia or Iceland, Okinawa, Elsinore, Brigadoon, Oklahoma, the South Pacific, or our town. Time travel, on any evening, afternoon, or early morning, we can return to ancient Egypt, classical Greece, imperial Rome, Elizabethan England, the France of Joan of Arc, California and the Gold Rush, or in one play travel from Cairo to Paris to Istanbul to Washington, D.C.
Raise the dead. In any or all of these times or places, people live again. Sir Thomas More, Henry David Thoreau, Emily Dickinson, Mark Twain, Elizabeth herself, plus a million casual strangers some playwright met and liked or despised or wondered about centuries ago. But we do not merely watch these people, uncomprehending as tourists. At those moments when real living people would stand stuttering, stammering, or trembling with illiterate rage, these fascinating people open their mouths and speak their thoughts aloud. Hamlet comes on and in 10 words speaks the tormenting choice that underlies the ecstasies and agonies of every adolescent. Frankie Adams articulates the confusions and discoveries that mark the end of childhood. King Lear screams the anger of old age. And Eliza Doolittle, happily awake in bed, peeks from under the covers and confides in us that she could have danced all night.
But excuse me, there is never a Hamlet, a Frankie Adams, a King called Lear, nor an Eliza Doolittle. And yet they have appeared alive and joyous in literally thousands of places. Simultaneously, on 100 stages at once around the world, these absolute hallucinations reoccur. We have seen the creation of life so often that we have forgotten it is a miracle. Telepathy, it is telepathic to travel in the minds of geniuses throughout ancient and imaginary lives of forefathers and phantoms for all eternity. What are the scientists and the statesmen troubling themselves for? Are they sitting there in the dark beside us all as we side by side, rank on rank, people who might not even be willing to talk to one another outside the theater, laugh together and gasp together, and are not even ashamed to cry because we can hear others in the dark around us crying? It isn't another kind of mind reading, a growing together of spirits that makes 2,000 people laugh simultaneously at the silliest slapstick joke.
These incredible treasures are everywhere. Everywhere that there is an empty space, a poet, actors, and an audience. When they ask you, what is theater for? Simply tell them, It does what every other field of human endeavor is struggling to do.
During the 6th century BC, one of the writers of tragedy who won the approval of the priests at the festival of Dionysus was Thespis. About 535 BC, a new dimension was added to drama when Thespis, a prominent leader of the chorus, stepped from that group and recited portions of the drama alone, thereby becoming the first actor. We also believe that it was he who first used masks so that a person could portray more than one part.
In honor of this early Greek playwright, all actors are called thespians. In his honor, we are the International Thespian Society. We have as our emblem the two masks of comedy and tragedy, etched in colors of gold and blue, bound together with a thespian T. Wearers of this emblem should remember that it represents a proud and dignified heritage, and that this heritage is now entrusted to us.
The following students have met the requirements for membership in the International Thespian Society, an honor and a reward for their participation in the theater program at this school. Each of you, 8 new inductees, will receive a membership card, certificate, and pin. Eleanor Anderson, Emma Berry, Hannah Rose Bruntrup, Simon Domeyer, Zoe Livingston, Peter Olson, Natalie Peting, and Molly Thompson.
This certificate serves as evidence of the honor you have received for helping to promote the theater arts program in this school. This membership card is your identification as a thespian. This will serve as a reminder of the responsibilities you assumed when accepting membership in the society.
This induction pin of gold and blue will indicate to others that you are part of an honored international group. May you wear it with pride.
While membership in the society is an honor, it is also evidence of your continuing desire to work toward higher standards for theater productions in education and the arts programs. Therefore, membership places upon you the obligation of performing your best with the knowledge that greater honors come to those who accept greater responsibilities through cooperation with others. I now ask all new members of Thespian Troop 4718 to repeat the pledge after me. I promise to uphold the aims and ideals of the International Thespian Society. I am a student of theater, and excellence is my ideal. I promise to perform my part as well as I can, to accept praise and criticism with grace, to cooperate with my fellow thespians, and work for the good of the troupe, and to share my love of theater. The pledge that you have just taken binds you to the principles and ideals of the International Thespian Society. You are to do the tasks assigned to you. You are to cooperate with your troop officers and fellow students, as well as your teachers and administrators, in helping to raise the standards of excellence in all areas of your experience. You are to refrain from any action that may hinder your work of your troop. You are to conduct yourselves so that you may gain the respect of your school or program and your community. By the authority delegated in me by the International Thespian Society, I now declare you members of troop number 4718 of Matamidi High School. Congratulations and welcome to the International Thespian Society. Always remember our motto, which comes from Alexander Pope's essay on man. Act well your part. There all the honor lies.
Congratulations, everyone. To be inducted into the International Thespian Society, a student needs to have earned 10 points through the work in theater productions and events. For every 10 points earned thereafter, an honor is bestowed upon that thespian. Congratulations to these current non-senior honor thespians. Two-star thespians are Jane Dean, Emma Berry, Natalie Peetig, Zoe Livingston, Annika Swanson, Hannah Rose Bruintrup, Abigail Brown. Three-star thespians, Jordan Rollinger, Zala Pearson, Brady Boland. We have a four-star thespian, Jay Cray, a five-star thespian, John Scripp, a seven-star honor thespian, Luke Wisniewski, and an eight-star honor thespian, Genevieve Lavallee. Make some noise for these thespians who have earned honors.
Senior thespian members who have honors will be presented with stickers to put on their certificate and pins for their honor ribbons. Mr. Garls will be in touch with the following seniors on how they can get their honor materials. Troop 4718 honor seniors are two-star thespian is Molly Thompson. Three-star thespians, Lucy Carlin and Brandon Galeazzi, Max Laxo. Five-star thespians are Sylvia Kemp and Sarah Lisowski. And an eight-star honor thespian is Anna Martinson. Congratulations for your years of hard work and leadership.
And now, this year's thespian officers and troop directors wanted to better define the roles of the officers for the future. Together, the following lists and duties were created. The goal is to have the drama club thespian troop that is more active, that is a more active community, not just during shows, but throughout the entire year. So, the state thespian officer duties will include attend monthly officer meetings, attend monthly drama club thespian meetings, report from STO meetings to officers and students. The ZPAF representative duties will include attend monthly officer meetings, attend monthly drama club thespian meetings, attend monthly ZPAF meetings, and present the report from student officers to ZPAF. Last, report the ZPAF report from ZPAF back to the drama club thespians. The social media liaison historian will attend monthly officer meetings, attend monthly drama club thespian meetings, be responsible for newspaper, e-news, press releases, create and distribute publicity for all events, create and maintain all social media platforms, and document all troop activities. The membership coordinator will attend monthly officer meetings, attend monthly drama club thespian meetings, maintain accounting of thespian points earned after every event in conjunction with the director, the assistant director, and the stage manager, prepare thespian induction and award form in conjunction with the troop sponsor, assist in ordering and organizing of awards, work with the vice president to create chapter guide and to guide chapter activities. Examples from other troops are Battle of the Bands, sing-offs, children's theater workshops, NATT variety shows, film festival, murder mystery, and troop outings. The secretary will attend monthly officer meetings, attend monthly drama club thespian meetings, take minutes of each meeting, email those to the historian and the ZPAF parent representative, be responsible for electronic communication on an ongoing and daily basis. The vice president duties will include attend monthly officer meetings, attend monthly drama club thespian meetings, serve as president in the president's absence, guide the committee for activities with the membership chair. The president duties will include schedule, attend, and lead monthly officer meetings in conjunction with the troop director, schedule, attend, and lead monthly drama club thespian meetings, establish agenda in conjunction with the troop director. Now, the following thespians will represent our thespian troop as officers for the 2021 school year. Our state thespian officer is Genevieve LaValle. ZPAF representative is also Genevieve LaValle. Social media liaison / historian is Hannah Rose Bruintrup. Membership coordinator, Jordan Rollinger. Secretary, Annika Swanson. Vice President John Scripp, and President Zala Pearson. Congratulations, and we look forward to your leadership next year. Our junior officers will now present special awards to our seniors.
The award for Most Glorious Hair goes to Owen Hergenrader. The award for Best One-Handed Acting goes to Kate Kelly. The award for Most Fly Performer goes to Lucy Carlin. And the award for Best One-Man Bass Section goes to Brandon Galeazzi.
Next, we have Lucas Olson for being the best keyboard player who isn't actually a keyboard player. Next, we have Josie Allen for most post-it notes wasted in the span of one performance. The next award goes to Parker Blossom for being the Swiss Army crew member, since she can do basically everything. And the next award goes to Aline Chornvliet for being the only person in theater to never step foot backstage.
To Sylvia Kemp for being told no by Joan the most amount of times. To Max Laxo for the most juice boxes distributed. To Anna Martinson for the most amount of yellow ever worn on the Chautauqua stage. to Sarah Lazowski for basically living in the CFAC.
Next year's season. So the fall show will be November 20th through 22nd, and you're going to see a slide with some bullet points. I'd like to see if you can guess the title from the following hints. It is based on a novel which shares its exact name, premiered in 2012 at the Royal National Theatre, won 7 Olivier Awards. The Broadway production closed after 800 performances, and it won 5 Tony Awards. It presents a fun and massive challenge to light, sound, and backstage crew. As the play progresses, a journey is taken, a dead person resurfaces, and a mystery is solved. And the show is The Curious Incident of the Dog in the Nighttime. This is a show by Simon Stevens and is based on a novel of the same name by Mark Haddon. During the show, we follow 15-year-old Christopher Boone, who lives with an autism spectrum condition that makes him not so great at reading emotions, but excellent at maths. And we follow Christopher as he tries to figure out who killed his neighbor's dog. The stage and the lighting are meant to represent Christopher's mind. So it is usually a black box on which we project lights and images to represent the emotions that Chris can't express. This show will challenge all of us to present the autism spectrum conditions and divorce thoughtfully and authentically while it pushes our tech department to its absolute limits. The book is short and definitely worth a summer read. I hope you pick it up soon before November.
I'm Marianne Elliott. I'm the director of the show Curious Incident of the Dog in the Nighttime.
I'm Bunny Christie. I'm the set and costume designer.
I'm Alex Sharp, and I play Christopher Boone.
Christopher's got a very unique and wonderful and extraordinary and imaginative brain. And the lighting, the set, the projection, the music and the sound are all supporting the fact that this is inside his view of the world.
It needed to be a world that Christopher would really love because he's the centre of this universe and he's the centre of the piece. So that meant that that world had to be full of maths and full of science and be very orderly and be very easy to keep in nice straight lines.
You walk into the theatre and it's this black grid system, very simple, very empty. But the ways in which it comes to life are extraordinary.
We've got lots of traps in the floor, and then there's cupboards and drawers in the walls as well that have anything that Christopher needs, he can kind of get immediately. So as soon as he kind of thinks about something, he can just go and get it. So it's his kind of world, really. He's in charge of it.
If he decides he wants to be in the kitchen, he's immediately in the kitchen. And the only prop that we show is the prop that is interesting to him.
He can just use the walls as if they're the floor or the ceiling, or if he imagines that he's on an escalator, then suddenly the escalator's there right underneath his feet.
The actors are sitting around the edge, ready to jump in to whatever part of the story he wants to jump into, because he doesn't always tell the story chronologically because he's far too interesting for that.
Everyone in the room, along with the ensemble, are all sort of Christopher's brain microbes. We're all inside of this human being's brain.
The audience feels that Christopher is them. Christopher isn't different from them, he's actually them. And he experiences things in the way that we all experience them.
The ability to produce this next show in the winter is dependent upon obtaining the rights for the performance dates requested. The show will run from Thursday, February 4th through Sunday, February 7th. See if you can make any guesses based on the following facts. It has been seen by over 54 million people in over 39 productions in 14 languages. Oops, I'll go back to the first one. The show made its U.S. premiere in 2000. The show has premiered in more than 400 major cities worldwide, faster than any other musical in history. This is a jukebox musical. This show may have used more Lycra than any other musical in Broadway history. The ensemble is a crucial part of this show. And our winter musical will be Mamma Mia. On a small Greek island, Sophie dreams of a perfect wedding, one which includes her father giving her away. The problem? Sophie doesn't know who he is. Her mother, Donna, the former lead singer of the 1970s pop group Donna and the Dynamos, refuses to talk about the past. So, Sophie decides to take matter in her own hands. Sneaking a peek in her mother's old diaries, she discovers three possible fathers: Sam, Bill, and Harry. She secretly invites all three to the wedding, convinced that she'll know her father when she sees him. But when all three turn up, it may not be as clear as she thought. Told through the legendary music of ABBA, Mamma Mia has become a worldwide sensation that has audiences everywhere dancing. Our spring musical will run from Thursday, April 29th through Sunday, May 2nd. See if you can make any guesses based on the following facts. This musical garnered 8 Tony Awards and won 1 Tony. It ran on Broadway for 1 year and 3 months during the years 2007 and 2008. The show had mixed reviews even though it won an award for Best Book of a Musical, and it had the top of the line cast that won awards for Best Featured Actress in a Musical and Best Leading Actor in a Musical. The musical featured a musical within a musical about the Old West, and it is a musical mystery comedy with a large cast. Our spring musical next year will be Curtains. Curtains takes place in Boston in 1959. At the Colonial Theater, the cast of Robin Hood of the Old West takes their bows on opening night. Just as the curtain falls, so does Jessica Crenshaw, the profoundly untalented leading lady of the production. Enter Lieutenant Frank Chaffee, a fast-talking cop with a love for musical theater. He quarantines the cast and crew inside the theater while he searches for clues. But Chaffee doesn't just investigate the murder. He also offers advice and insight into improving Robin Hood. The musical will open again in 24 hours with a new leading lady, so the clock is ticking to find the killer and put on a killer show. Who could it be? Carmen Bernstein, the sassy and brassy producer? Christopher Belling, the campy and egotistical director? Georgia Hendrix, the lyricist who replaces Jessica on stage. Nikki Harris, the ingenue with a secret. Everyone is a suspect, and only Chaffee can make sense of the evidence. Curtains is a musical theater parody of whodunit classics.
Putting on a musical has got to be the most fulfilling thing a person could ever hope to do. You're a special kind of people known as show people. You live in a world of your own. The audience paid plenty to sit there and clap, hearing you sing, watching you tap. Did you know your dentist longs to be in show business? Your window washer wants to be a star. And though your analyst may never couch it that way,
analyst couch,
you don't know how lucky you are. Some policemen and detectives dream of show business. They can't get arrested, but still they sit around the station and fancy this life. Oh, they cheer Sherlock Holmes and cheer Mac the Knife.
Ask your cleaning lady, don't you dream of show business? To vocalize, stretch beside a bar.
Her affirmative shrug as she shampoos your rug lets you know.
There's a special kind of aura around a show person. Just ask the next waiter you meet. He walks in fifth position, his voice is just grand.
He gives you the check, you give him a hand.
We're a special kind of people, no yes, show people.
We want each and every one of you to know that we adore you and have missed you so much. We don't know what the future brings for the performing arts, but we do know that we will do what is safest and best for all of you. We may have to be creative in how we move forward in the fall, but there will still be an MHS theater community. Thank you for an amazing season. Your hard work and passion amaze us every day. Seniors, thank you so much for all you've done for this program. We are better because of you. You have definitely made a difference, and the CFAC will seem so much emptier without you. Please know that you are always a Zephyr Theater student, and you are always welcome here. Good night.